Like the title of this video says, I am finally on peritoneal dialysis. Originally, I had to go through two or three weeks worth of training, 3 days a week, plus doing dialysis 3 days a week. And all of it was, you know, 3 or 4 hours at a time, always right in the middle of the day. Finally got through all of that mess, and now, like I said, I'm on peritoneal dialysis, which means I actually do dialysis at home. And I'm actually doing that right now as I'm recording this video, laying here in bed. Thought it would be a good opportunity to kind of talk about it a little bit and show you what it is I have to do here. So, first thing I have to do every time is, let's see if we can get a good angle here, this tube that you can see here actually goes into my stomach right here, and it is both a fill port and a drain port. So right now I'm in the process of draining the fluid that has been kind of sitting in my peritoneum for about the last 3 or 4 hours. And that's usually a 20 to 25 minute process. And then once it's done, then I get to, then I have to shut this valve right here and essentially switch the lines from drain to fill. And then the fill process is like another 20 minutes or so. And to give you an idea of the amount of fluid we're talking about, for each of my treatments, and presently I have to do four treatments a day, and each treatment takes, about a total of an hour. It's about a 10-minute process to set up, 20-minute process to drain, 20-minute process to fill, and like another 10 minutes to get everything all cleaned up and disposed of properly and that sort of thing. So once the drain is done, and that's a full 2 liters of fluid that I'm trying to get out of my system, once that's done, like I said, I close the port, switch to fill mode, and then up here, this bag is 2 liters of a dextrose solution that they use for peritoneal dialysis. It's not a saline solution like you would expect to see, you know, like in an IV drip or something like that. This is actually a sugar solution that goes into the stomach cavity area. It fills up, sits for a while, and the stuff that's in your system is actually attracted to that dextrose, and then is taken out of the system through this flush. So yeah, like I said, I'll end up doing this 4 times a day for the next 2 to 4 weeks. And that sucks, because takes up a lot of time. Like I said, it's each one is about an hour long, every 3 hours. So my days are pretty tied up now doing this. But the nice thing about it is once we get through this part, this 2 to 3 weeks, then we'll go, I'll end up switching over to a cycler machine, which will be a lot nicer, because I'll just hook up at night using the same port that I'm currently using, and then I'll just do the dialysis overnight. And then at that point, my days will hopefully be a bit more freed up, and I won't be quite so busy with doing dialysis all of the time. I will still be doing it 7 days a week, but instead of taking up 4 hours of my day, it'll be an automated process throughout the evening. So I will say that one of the downsides to the peritoneal dialysis is that, like I said, I've got this port in my stomach, and there's this one catheter that goes in, and it coils up kind of down in the bottom of my pelvis, and that's normally not a problem, but sometimes it will shift just a little bit, and it doesn't hurt when it shifts, but when I'm draining, sometimes the holes that are on it, that are on that little spiraled up tube that's in there, there are holes that line the outside of it, and sometimes when it shifts, it'll press up against like my colon or something down in that area, and essentially it will act like you know, like if you've got like a vacuum cleaner with just the hose attachment, and you put your hand on the end of it, how it'll like suck your hand to it, and the vacuum will make a big noise and whatnot. This doesn't make a big noise, but it's kind of that same thing, except that it's sucking my insides to that tube, and sometimes it hurts a lot to have that tube sucked up against the inside your organs there, and essentially trying to suck them into those little holes. So every once in a while, I've got to stop my drain and take a break and move around a little bit to see if I can't get it repositioned before I try again. All right, so this right here is the bag of fluid that I've just drained out of me. About 3 hours ago, a little over 3 hours ago, I put 2 liters, or yeah, 2 liters in. And if we look here, we actually have to weigh these. Let's see if I can get, so I'm at about 1.9 liters, and just with the amount of pain that I'm dealing with at this point, I'm going to go ahead and just leave that last little bit in there, and then here in just a second, I'm going to switch directions, and I'm going to take this 2-liter bag, and it's going to actually go down this tube all the way through there, and I'm going to switch this clamp right here, and I'll just go ahead and do it. I'm going to switch it from this line. All right, I'm going to count to 5, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's good. And then I'm going to clamp like so. Oh, you know what? It didn't work right because I need to take this down. I can do it one-handed here. All right, so now I want to get, like here you can see these little air bubbles here, and there's a few of them in this line, and I want to try to get some of those out, like so. And all I did was just unclamped this drain clamp here for just a second, and then we can go through and we can inspect, like this little wire right here, make sure there's no air bubbles in it, and then we just kind of look up the line here, and make sure there's nothing in there. Sometimes like it trapped up in this little area right here. Yeah, a little one in there. Yeah, see. Get all those air bubbles out of there. Alright, so now we've got all the air bubbles out, and then I'm gonna reach down to right here. And open that port. And then if we come up here, you might be able to see it. Yeah, you can watch that level go down. Actually, faster than I ever figured it really would. As it going down this tube, and then right into, right there on me, right there. But this is gonna go faster. It's going okay. But it'll actually go faster if I lay down. All right, so now that that's filling me back up, basically, now I just lay here and wait like 20 minutes or so for it to drain that full 2 liters from the bag into my peritoneum. And then I just gotta close everything up, dispose of the waste bag, and I'm done again until this evening, until I've got to do it again. But the next one I do will actually be an overnight. So I'll drain this 2 liters I'm putting in now, and then we'll put 2 liters back in, go to bed, and then in the morning when I wake up, I will start the process over again, Do it 4 more times tomorrow, and the day after, and the day after, and the day after. So, yeah, that's me right now. All right, guys, so I think that's going to wrap it up for this one. All the normal stuff applies here, like, subscribe, comment. But in the comment section, if you've got any questions for me, basically, whatever questions you've got, leave those in the comment section below, and maybe we can start doing a Q&A thing on here. So, yeah, like I said, I'm going to wrap it up here. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you in the next one.